Hi guys, and welcome back to my channel. It's your girl Sydney with a C. If you are new here, my name is Sydney. Welcome. Today I wanted to talk about my 10 favorite books of 2019. All right guys, so this list is in no particular order. These are just 10 books that I really enjoyed for the year of 2019. So for the first book on my list, it is going to be Madam X by Jacinda Wilder. This was actually my very first review on the channel, and I really wanted to incorporate it because I was so emotional while reading this book. This book brought out so many emotions as I was reading it, and it was just amazing to feel that way as a reader. And now that I finished the first book, I gotta keep going. I need to know what happened. It's a 3-book series. It is erotic lit as well as new adult romance. So there's a lot going on in this story. So the gist, pretty much, Madam X is a teacher hired to transform wealthy men into dominant, attractive, confident men that women would want to talk to. While she does this for a living, she really has her own secret. Underneath that hard Madam X exterior, she is this confused, entrapped woman in a life that she has no way of getting out of, and she is being controlled by another person. And this man has put it in her head that she is literally nobody, and he's the person that brought her to where she is, and he's done so much good for her. It is truly an emotional roller coaster for the main character, and I felt that the entire time I read it. And that's what I loved about the story. Now, this is a very, how do I put this? It's very dark story when it gets further in. If you have like certain triggers on certain conversations, definitely beware. Definitely would recommend it to someone who enjoys erotic lit, new adult romance, and taboo topics. The second book on my list is The Restorer by Amanda Stephens, and it's a paranormal fiction and romance novel, and oh my good gugga mugga, it is so good. It's so good. If I had a top 5 and I had to rank them, this would be number 1 for sure. I love this book. It's about Amelia, who is a graveyard restorer, and it is kind of like a family business thing, and she branched off and created her own business out of it. So she is currently, like, in the story, restoring I believe a college campus's graveyard. She happens to be there when a murder investigation is going on, and the detective is like questioning her to make sure that she has nothing to do with it. And once she is like singled out, she is then asked to be a part of the investigation, and oh my gosh, it just gets crazier from there. And she finds out through her gift that she has. Sorry, did I say that? She has a gift. She has a gift where she can see ghosts, feel them, sense them. She can tell when the veil has been lifted or when it's going down. Fast forward, she is sensing a pull to the detective, and come to find out he has his own little ghost secret of his own. So she gets so attached to him that she ends up finding out like the truth of what's going on. She gets so close that she is too close to being attached to the veil that she can't be a part of. It's an awesome, awesome, awesome murder mystery. I really enjoyed it so much, and I can't wait to finish the rest of the series. I will definitely, definitely do a review on it for sure. Number 3 on my list is going to be The Bells by Donyell Clayton, and I absolutely love this book. I was surprised by this one as well. This book was an easy top 5 favorite as well because of the conversation it has about body image, and that's what I really loved about this book the most. The main character is Camellia Beauregard, and she is set in the crazy world of Orleans. I actually have a review for this book, and I did it in this like lame southern accent, but that's how I read the entire book. It was great. I really enjoyed it. So the synopsis pretty much is that Camellia and her sisters are getting ready to go to the kingdom and get ready to be chosen to figure out who's going to be the number one girl that can stay in the castle, and she gets to transform people pretty much as a job. The big thing in the set of Orleans is that everyone's so wrapped up in beauty because they're naturally not born with beauty. They're chasing this fad. That's what I really enjoyed about it. It was a fad. Everyone's trying to fit in and trying to be the most beautiful, and the only way to reach that is by going to a bell. And these bells have a gift as well, and it's called Arcana, where they can transform your body. And it hurts, but they make sure they make it as painless as possible. What I love so much about the story was the main character had so much integrity about her. She was willing to tell people that you don't need this done to you. You look great the way you are. For the sake of the story, everyone was not listening to her. She was considered a problem. It just gets deeper and darker, and I loved that it got darker, and I'm gonna leave it at that. It was a really great story. I do have the second book and I can't wait to read that one as well. So the fourth book on my list is going to be Dirty Billionaire by Megan March, and I actually read this book in the first week in December. I actually read the entire series. I was so surprised at how much I really enjoyed it. I read two chapters in and I realized how much I was enjoying what I was reading, and I just kept going. I didn't care what chapters I was on, and then the story ended and I had to go pick up the next two books so that I knew everything that happened in this series. And I ended up reading it all before Friday that week, which is crazy because I never read that fast. I read the entire series, and this first book is the one that's on the list. Pretty much the introduction to everything. Holly Wicks Wickman is an upcoming star in Nashville, country singer, and she's in a bit of a jam with her record label. She gets put in a situation that is very, very tough to be in, especially if you're trying to rise to fame. And she tries to cope with that, and she makes a very hasty decision that really changed her life for debatably the good and the bad. And she ends up finding herself in a situation with the ever so handsome billionaire Creighton Karas, and he is a take no shit kind of guy. He has it his way, the first way and the only way, and he is so dominating over her that it becomes this power struggle. It's a very, very good book. It is a romance novel. I really enjoyed it. It's romance and erotic lit. So the very first book is very, very erotic and romancy towards the end. And then the rest of the series definitely draws in on the romance side of it with some sex in there as well. So anybody under 18, I do not encourage you to read this book. If you are over 18, fair game, but I am not recommending to anybody that is underage. Yeah, I really enjoyed this book, and I would definitely look forward to continuing the series if there was like more books to come. It was really good. The fifth book on my list is Stalking Jack the Ripper by Carrie Maniscalco, and I absolutely adore this series. Why? Because I can relate to this main character so much. She loves, loves, loves science, and I love science. I'm actually a nursing major, so this is like right up my alley. Anybody that has read this book has seen those pictures in that first book of the, you know, everything Jack the Ripper related, and I absolutely love that that book has that in it. I love it. The main character, she's 17, Audrey Rose Wadsworth, and she is definitely not supposed to like forensic science. Why? Because it's Victorian era London and women don't have rights. Not at all. Women, you can't sneeze without being offensive. And by gosh, she breaks those barriers, and I love every minute of it. Audrey Rose Wadsworth's uncle is a forensic scientist himself, and he works with Scotland Yard to help bring in these corpses that have been mutilated, and they're all women, I believe. I believe one is male. They're trying to figure out what is going on. Who could this be? Why? It's Jack the Ripper. So pretty much they go on this journey, and Audrey Rose Wadsworth puts herself in a situation where she has to figure out what is happening in London and why is this person killing. And it was quite interesting, and I really enjoyed it so much. It is a YA fantasy novel, I believe you would call it that. I am 3 books deep into this series. I can't wait to finish Escaping Houdini. I am reading it right now, and I really can't wait to finish the series. So the sixth book on my list is City of Glass by Cassandra Clare, and I'm really not going to talk much about this book because it's all over BookTube, all over Bookstagram. Everybody talks about the Shadowhunter series. It is OG. I'm gonna be honest with you guys, none of these books are really brand spanking new in my top 10 list. I've been quite behind on my books since I've been in college because textbooks are awful and they make your eyes cry. City of Glass. I am stuck on that third book. I have not completed the series yet, and I'm stuck on the third book because I'm quite nervous of what comes after now that it ended the way it did. So if you've only read to book 3, I would love to talk about it with you and conspire with you. The seventh book on my list is Simon versus the Homo Sapien Agenda by Becky Albertalli. I absolutely adored this book. It was so sweet, so innocent. And yes, the things that go on in the book are not exactly innocent, but this felt like such a sweet and soft book that I can't complain. So Simon is, he's gay. So this is a LGBT book, and he's in high school. He has not told anybody that he is gay, and the only person that knows is Blue, who he emails like all the time. And come to find out, Blue goes to his school. So this reminded me right off the bat of another Cinderella story, and I was here for it. I was here for this love connection created through email. So the main conflict in the story is that Simon is being blackmailed by the class clown Martin, who has a crush on one of his friends. And the blackmail is emails that Simon has sent with Blue, the secret character that is floating around the same high school as him. This story was so cute, and it is a tale of love, a tale of friendship, and a tale of doing the right thing. Just go read that book. It was really good. I do not care for the movie as much, but the book was pretty darn good. The eighth book on my list is going to be Zodiac by Romina Russell. I love this book. It got me out of comfort zone of switching genres. I'm not a big genre switcher. This was a sci-fi book, like heavy sci-fi, and I was so surprised. I loved it so much in the way that it played out throughout the entire series. It was all about astrological signs, and that's what I loved about it the most. This is a space story. We're on House Cancer in the beginning, and the main character, Roma Grace, is getting ready to take an assessment over again because she does it a different way than what she's taught in school. And the assessment is reading the stars. So that is something every person in the galaxy of the Zodiac has to do. And the way she sees it, every time she sees a vision happen, something bad happening to House Cancer. And she has told her teacher about this, and they just blew it off. When she retakes the assessment, she has that same vision, and her teachers blow her off again, and they tell her to retake it and do it the way they've taught her to do it. And she goes off and gets ready to perform for this big ceremony that's about to happen in front of some of the House Cancer officials. So when she gets ready and she goes and does that, she sits down, they begin to play, and just this huge explosion happens, and House Cancer comes crashing down onto the planet that she's sitting on. It's not a planet, it's a moon. And after that, it was just destroyed. People were dying, floating around, all ages, and they have to escape. So in the midst of them trying to escape, House Cancer is in need of a replacement house guardian, as their house guardian has died because of this explosion. And Roma Grace is given the responsibility of being the house guardian. From there, the story really takes off. She has to figure out what to do and read the stars the way she knows how to read them to find what the bigger issue is. She sees something that nobody else sees in the stars, and nobody can correlate what she's seeing in the stars. So this was a very cool and interesting story. I'm so happy I found this at Barnes & Noble's. It's definitely a highlight for 2019 of books that I read. The ninth book on my list is The Watchmaker's Daughter by CJ Archer, and this book means a lot more to me than any other book on this list because this is what really started me on doing a book review blog and starting me on Bookstagram. I found this book and I really enjoyed it because it's a historical fiction and it's fantasy, and it was a subtle fantasy element about it, and that's what really drew me in because I wanted to know more about what does this everyday thing have to do with magic. And the synopsis really is about India Steele, the main character. She's in Victorian era London. She has her inheritance taken from her by her fiance because he can do that in that time period, and her inheritance is her father's watch repair store. So he is a part of the Clockmakers Guild. India knows how to fix watches, put them together, take them apart, and then create her own if she wanted to. And she does not know why this is happening to her. So she has become desperate for money because she's been kicked out of her home, kicked out of her inheritance, kicked out of her own shop. She can't get a job. The watchmakers across the city will not give her a job because of the fact that she's a woman. And it seems like as she continues to go find a job that they are repulsed by her, and she doesn't know why. So along the way, she meets a man looking for a specific watchmaker. His name is Matt Glass, and he ends up enlisting her for help to find this watchmaker because she's desperate, he's desperate. Why not be desperate together? Why not? So they go across the city asking these watchmakers, where is this watchmaker? Where is this guy that made this watch for me in America a long time ago? What's so great about the story is that it unfolds and becomes into a mystery, a murder mystery, and I really enjoyed the way it just was a trickle effect. This is a whole series. I'm currently on book 4. This book was really cool. I definitely had to put it on my list because it helped me start from somewhere, and I enjoyed the historical fiction in it, the fantasy elements, and the romance of the story. It's really good for just a basic quick read. The very last book on my list is The Fourth Courier by Timothy J. Smith. And this one is on my list because it was a very awesome, interesting read. I don't know much about the Cold War era and the communist era, but this book really got me interested, if that makes sense. This is a fiction thriller murder mystery novel. And I was actually contacted by the author to read this to do an honest review, and I never got to do one on here. I enjoyed the book so much that I would recommend it to people that like books like that. Pretty much, it is a 1992 Warsaw, Poland, and the communist era has just ended. There is a series of murders going on, and it's become an international case because the people that are being killed are believed to be couriers who are smuggling nuclear material to create a bomb. Now, the U.S. sends one FBI agent over to Poland to assimilate to the culture and blend in order to figure out what's going on. Along the way, he goes to the embassy and meets one other FBI agent that is going to be his partner, and they begin to blend in with the people and make friends and basically live life like it's normal to be there. And eventually, the pieces start falling together that all of these people that they just happen to meet are somehow connected to the bigger picture in the story. And it turns out to be really, really interesting, and I love the way the ending ties together. Because like I said, all of the characters in the story are some way attached to it. And I felt the excitement build as it got closer and closer. The author really did a great job with that, and that's gonna wrap up my 10 favorite books of 2019. I will definitely link them down below for everyone to see to check out those books. I really enjoyed doing this video for you. I'm gonna post more book videos coming soon. I can't wait to do that, but until then, go forth and read, write, and watch movies.